Hey guys, Mr. Dalek JD here, and welcome to an awesome zombies video where I'm going to be informing you of some information which you probably haven't heard of. Well, a few days ago, a user called TomBMX managed to find out all the coding for zombies on Black Ops 2, and there's a lot of text that is a bit strange and opens up some new game modes, some new perks, some new maps for us to play on in the future, which is also very, very nice. So there's this image right here I'm going to have on screen, and it looks a bit like the town area with just like the lights and the signs with saying different things. But in the actual coding, it says this: zombies are attracted to the team with the meat. Stay alive as long as you can by throwing the meat to your opponent's side. And you see in the middle of this picture here, you see what looks like this like arrow, and it's sort of making a sort of ring shape. And what I'm guessing here is that there are two teams, and the teams, one of the teams has this meat, and they've got to chuck it towards this, like, the other team. And I guess it's kind of like not a free-for-all, but almost like a kind of, like, challenge for whoever ends the round holding the meat is the loser. And the other parts of the coding, it says, your team has the meat, the other team has the meat, you saved yourself with that throw, you don't want that, your team has the meat, you have the meat, and it says, press blah 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 to throw meat, press blah blah to get rid of the meat, and hold to pick up the meat, which is very interesting. And also, in the same kind of general area in the coding, it says to hold to activate the flame barrier, which costs 500 points. We've also got a variety of perks, including Deadshot, Stamina Up, PhD, a Mule Kick, which are the perks we have not seen in Green Run Transit mode. And another very, very interesting thing is the fact that there's also the option, I'm not sure if this is just specific to this meat game mode that's speaking about here, but there's also an option to buy Damage Aid and to buy Candoila, which are perks which were originally going to be in Dereze, but they got cancelled. So that's very, very interesting. Another thing to point out is also in this coding, there's also talking about stuff like hold to trade equipment for PES and to activate PES, and it's in the same line as pick up zombie shield and take zombie shield. And if you aren't aware, PES was the helmet system that you wore in Moon to breathe, of course, when you're outside, and also it was a way to kind of communicate with your team because you could hear all the characters' quotes as loud as if you were actually that character, which is very, very interesting. Taking a look at most of the new game modes that are being shown in this coding, we've got Transit, we've got Survival, then we've got Containment, Race, which I think kind of links in with Meat a little bit. I can kind of see that kind of screenshot map being also kind of a race kind of thing as well. Deadpool, Meat, No Man's Land, which is very interesting, Turned, Pitted, Returned, Grief, that we all know and love, and Cornfield, which is basically we're going to be dropped into the cornfields as an actual playable map. Looking further into the code, there's actually more list of game modes and locations. So of course we've got Transit with 1-4 players, and we've got Survival Town 1-4 players. We've also got Cleansed Cornfield 1-4 players, and I think what these cleansed might be is literally just a form where the whole kind of map area is cleansed. It's not exactly as kind of like harshly foggy as it is at the moment. Like, you could imagine just like, say for instance the game Slender, you know, it's set at night. I guess a cleansed version is just daytime where everything's really fresh. You've got Cleansed Cornfield, Cleansed Diner, which is previously a map that we can't play on just on its own, Cleansed Farm, which again we can already play, but when it comes to a Cleansed Town, we can also play that as well. And they've also got Survival on Farm, which we already have, and Survival on Bus Depot, which we already have. Then we've got Meat, which is going to be in the farm, the town, and interestingly, the tunnel as well. That's very, very cool. On the Race, we've got four different maps. There's Farm, there's the Power Room, which is going to be very weird to think on how you could run around in that very tight area, Town, and Tunnel. And then they also want to introduce Grief in the entire Green Run map in general. Now, do take into consideration that this might not actually ever happen at all, but it's just hidden like files within the actual game files of hidden game modes. Now, I knew about this whole Meat game mode back in September, but I didn't really say anything about it. And it's just a lot of very, very cool stuff to tell you guys right now that I thought I'd just bring you the information as well. Another really cool thing is the fact that all of the loading screens from the old World at War maps are also hidden in the game files as well as a load of different things thrown back to them, which I'll show you guys now. Okay, this is absolutely mad. As you can see, it says Kena the Toten, and then it gives a load of options and stuff that you can turn on or off. Now, we know that we can turn magic on and off, but this looks absolutely mad. Look, you can have mutators, which will have no perks, no traps, no magic box, no revives, no power-ups, reloads, boards, fog match, quick start, headshots only, no dogs, dogs only, friendly fire, double money, susceptible, and power shot. And that's all stuff that you can change. And if this is true, then we're going to have Kena the Toten back, playable in Black Ops 2, as well as a few other different Black Ops 1 maps, which is going to be absolutely amazing if that is true. Now, I know I showed you this earlier, but take a look at this. Not only is there Nachtan Toten, but there's also Dereze, as well as Moon. And we've got that new, kind of like, look, as you can see there, Meat on the Tarmac, brackets race. And I guess kind of maybe the whole meat and race thing build into one, like I mentioned at the start, where like the team has a piece of meat and they've got to throw it towards the other team, and it's a race to see who comes out without the meat. I guess that's the way that I'm thinking it, but do let me know your thoughts down below as well. I've also got down below there, as you can see, Meat on the Tarmac brackets Deadpool as well. So any like suggestions you have or ideas for like game modes or maps or what you'd like to see, just put that in the comment section down below as well. Really awesome to hear your feedback, as some pretty interesting coding, I'll give you that. So there's a brief little video for you guys there on a bit of the coding. There is tons more, and the link is in the description down below if you want to search for it and look at all the coding for yourself. There's a lot of zombie stuff mixed in with multiplayer, so it's going to take you a little while to search through. But I did see some stuff about Lunar Landers, which relates to Ascension, which is really awesome. But if you enjoyed this video, then be sure to give it a like rating, and that would be very, very awesome of you. And you can also go ahead and share it with your friends, perhaps send it to them on Facebook or tweet it out, just whatever you want to do. And if you haven't already, do subscribe for more videos like this to inform you. And any new official DLC announcements and trailers will be on my channel, as well as loads and loads of storyline videos and just gameplay tips and commentaries. See you guys very soon.